While the future of shopping malls is uncertain, a new owner and developer have plans for transforming a closed space in Southlake Mall. Hi, I'm Haley with CPTV News. We're going to tell you about that. Plus, we'll break down last Friday's CP Lafayette Jeff sectional championship game. California-based company CubeWork recently purchased the former Carson's department store in Southlake Mall. The two-story, nearly 150,000 square foot space has been vacant since Carson's went out of business in 2018. New plans are to transform the former store into pop-up retail space, co-working space, and indoor sports, which could include activities like laser tag, escape rooms, game lounges, batting cages, virtual golf, and indoor pickleball fields. CubeWork hopes to open this move-in ready space as soon as November 15th. Hurricane Ian hit Florida in late September and most of the U.S. has moved on, but the work is a daily process and areas hit the hardest. Ian caused severe damage to roughly 15,000 homes and hundreds of people are still in shelters, depending on food and water from the Red Cross and other organizations. Many people are stuck carrying survivor's guilt and make it a priority to restore Fort Myers and other affected areas.
Driving around seeing what some people have compared to what we have left, you know, you get that survivor guilt thing. Trying not to.
Student Council will again team up with the American Red Cross to sponsor their annual blood drive. The event will take place on November 18th in the CPHS Fieldhouse. You can sign up this week at lunch or in rooms E216 or C14. Every pint of blood donated saves up to 3 lives. Every 2 seconds in this country, somebody needs blood. The schedule for the blood drive is available. Please see a Student Council member for details and times.
Hi, I'm Madeline with CPTV News. The Crown Point City Council pre-approved the 200-home Willow subdivision, which was set between 129th Avenue and Delaware Street. What effects will this have on our community? Will there be enough jobs or room in schools for 200 new families? On top of this, developers presented an idea for a $185 million development near I-65 and 231.
We'll need to kind of represent the responsible growth and development, which is anticipated for Crown Point.
It's expected to enhance economic growth and improve traffic. Are you afraid of the future of artificial intelligence and robots gaining consciousness? Then this may freak you out a bit the first time you see it. CPHS purchased an autonomous floor cleaner, which is programmed to clean all hallway floors after school by itself.
We dust mop the floors, drive the machine to the scan tag, scan it, let it go, and it cleans the floors all by itself.
We think it's a great machine that helps us keep our buildings safe and clean for students and staff, and it allows our custodial staff to really dig deep into classrooms and restrooms and areas where students spread more germs, and without taking so much time to clean the floors.
The cost of machines who perform these types of jobs lists between $8,000 and $9,000 each. By now, most of you know the CP football team's undefeated season came to a close last Friday in the sectional championship game versus Lafayette Jefferson. For the second week in a row, the Dogs came out slow and trailed 14-7 at the half. CP did find their offense in the second half, and every time the Broncos pulled ahead, the Dogs answered, trailing 31-28 with 2:48 left in the game. But the Broncos QB Ethan Smith and running back Glenn Patterson showed out with a combined 408 yards and 4 touchdowns. And this proved to be too much for CP, falling 38-28 and ending their season at 10-1. The girls basketball team faced Kankakee Valley in their home opener last Saturday. After trailing in the first quarter, the Dogs allowed KV to score just 1 point in the second quarter, and it was all CP from there for the 52-36 win. CP junior Ava Zokowski led all scoring and rebounds with 16 and 11, respectively. Dogs are off over the weekend, but get back at it Tuesday night at Andrean with tip-off at 7.
Before we go, a quick look at our CP NWI weather forecast.
Remember, for the latest in CP and NWI news, check in regularly with CPTV News or thedogradio.com at the bottom of every hour. Follow us on Snapchat at CPTV_QuickCUT to catch a replay of this episode or any episodes you may have missed. See you next time.